bling and tons of things. I know you love so much. You're going to the devil. Hope you pack your song.
No more inhibitions. The show, girl.
Humble truth, a modest entertainment dedicated to the Las Vegas trifecta. Hits, glitz, and tips. Ah, Vegasers, I like to say, Oi, Vegas! The sinningest city in America. I'm so glad you're here. These are such strange and polarizing times, but at least we all agree on one thing. We all love me! Thank you. And why not? If anyone knows what you're going through, it is I, Miss M, the People's Diva. Thank you. I heard you sobbing in the wilderness. And thanks to a perfect combination of hormones and mood elevators, I stand before you salt and silicone free. In fact, every single boob on this stage is 100% real. Just like the day God made it. And speaking of real boobs, how about this trio right here, ladies and gentlemen? The Staggering Hollands! Woo-ha! Girls, go on down. Say hello to the nice people like I taught you.
Hello!
Aren't they gorgeous? These girls are just like family to me. They'll tell you I'm the biggest mother they ever worked for. And now let's take a moment to appreciate this bevy of beauties behind me, the Caesar Salad Girls! Each and every one a tomato. And always serve with as little dressing as possible. And here's the best part. Not one of them is a French-Canadian circus performer! Of seduction, I confess. As a room gets hotter, we'll be wearing even less. All the dolls are both dead. You might be here till dawn. You can't stop the show, girl.
You can't stop the show, girl. You can't stop the show, girl. When the show, girl, must go on.
Coliseum, what could be more exciting, more glamorous? Look, my confetti is falling down from the sky down around your shining little faces. I want you to know it's made from 100% recycled material. It's my 401k. All right, ladies and gentlemen, one more time, the Caesar Salad Girls. The Caesar Salad Girls. And the Staggering Harlots. There they go, the beautiful harlots. Oh, my goodness. Look at this stage, it's gigantic. But isn't it beautiful? I love it so much. Isn't it gorgeous? I know it's huge. Fannie Mae gave it to me with no money down. And an adjustable rate mortgage. I am so utterly screwed. I guess I won't be retiring anytime soon, huh? Just a little lesson I picked up from Cher. But enough about her and more about me. I feel so blessed to be standing here in front of 4,500 of my dearest friends. I think I'll sing a song about it. Oh, you got to have friends. The feeling's oh so strong. You got to have friends to make that day last long. Had some friends while they dust till the dawn. Here is where I'll stay, standing at the end of the road, boys, waiting for my new friends to come. I don't care if I'm hungry or cold. I gotta get me some, 'cause you got to have friends. the end of a real long road, waiting for my new friends to come. I don't care if I'm hungry or freezing my ass. I gotta get me, I gotta get me some friends. Talking about friends, singing about friends. Yeah. I got me. Well, that's what happens when you do your own singing. All right, and there they go, the staggering harlots. Harlots, walk it out. Word. Harlots, walk it out. Walk it out. Walk it out. Miss and walk it out. Miss and walk it out. Do the walk it out.
We gotta walk.
Okay. Oh my God. We have to pace ourselves. And not just because if I cross the stage one more time, I'll have a stroke. I don't dare overexert you either. 30 years ago, my audiences were on drugs. Now they're on medication. We gotta be careful. No seizures at Caesars. Say it with me now. No seizures. That's fabulous. Girls, bring me the transportation. I can't take another step. Oh, look, it's the Octomom's lips. I'm exhausted. Girls, wheel me down the front. I have to say hello to my peeps down front. My high rollers, you know. Both of them.
Look at that pair of smug motherfuckers. Honest to God.
All right, where are the Jews? My tribe. Where is my tribe? Oh, I think they're over there. I overheard someone complaining they were sitting in a draft. All right, Jews, how many of you came? Just because it's called the Colosseum and you thought we'd be throwing Christians to the lions. And where are the Christians? Where are they? Make some noise here. Oh, so cute. They love me. I'm the belle of the Bible Belt. And the gays, where are the gays? Oh, we have a few in the house tonight. Oh my goodness, the gays. They travel in packs. Trendy, well-groomed packs. They like to sit on my left. It's a political statement. Come on, girls, we're gonna go to the left. But we'd like to get there before I drop dead. Okay, girls? It's only a 90-minute show. Thank you. Gays on my... Well, actually, the gays are everywhere. But here at the Colosseum, especially, because I share the Colosseum with Cher. Does it get any gayer? And look, there we are. Me, Elton, and Cher. So young, so beautiful, huh? Just the girls. You know, back then we were considered the bad girls of rock and roll. But these women who are working in show business today, oh my God, they make us look like missionaries. What the hell is going on? The whole world has become one long episode of Girls Gone Wild. When did women start behaving in this most disturbing fashion? Showing their privates to the public for free! That's what I don't understand. That is scandalous. Ladies, have I taught you nothing? Has my life's work been in vain? I opened the door for trashy singers with bad taste and big tits, and don't you forget it. But now I'm the people's diva. And I have to tell you that as the people's diva, I lay awake nights worrying about which starlet's going to be next to be photographed coming out of a boat or a car without her damn underwear on. So tacky, so low, so vulgar. How does a trend like this get started? Well, you know, all it takes is one lowlife to decide she's going to make a spectacle of herself. And suddenly, it sweeps across the country. Is that me? That's not me, is it? Is that me? My eyes aren't what they once were. Is that me? Holy shit, that is me! Well, all I can say is, wow, what an amazing ass! Oh, and where has it gone? Where is my ass of yesteryear? I'll tell you where. The other day, I was taking a shower, and something bumped me behind my knee. It was my ass. Said, I'm just dropping in. All right. Enough about me and my privates. All right. We're going to sing a song now. I just love to sing this song. The only problem with this song is that everybody loves to sing it. Please don't. Until I give you the signal. And then you can take out your cell phone and do this to your heart's content. For those of you who haven't been to a concert since Jethro Tull, cell phones have replaced matches and lighters. And you can be fearless on this, because I'm standing here, and from where I'm standing, it looks so beautiful to see the whole auditorium lit up with the cell phones. It's gorgeous, so I think you'll enjoy it. Some say love, it is a river, and it drowns the tender reed. Some say love, it is a razor that leaves your soul to bleed. Some say love, it is a hunger, an endless and this aching need. I say love, it is a flower, and you, it's only seed.
Thank you.
dance? Do ya, do ya? Do you wanna dance? Do ya, do ya, do ya, do ya want to dance with me, baby? Ah, that's right. Oh, that's my favorite part.
Distance.
songs of peace. They're the songs of every man. From a distance, you look like my friend. Even though we are at war, and from a distance I just cannot comprehend what all this fighting is for. From a distance there is harmony, and it echoes through. It's the heart of every man. It's the hope of hopes, and it's the love of loves. This is the song of every man.
God is watching.
Oh,
yes.
He's watching.
God is watching.
From a distance.
Jump, jump, jump.
We had an apartment in the city. Me and my husband liked living there. And it's been years since the kids have grown. Left us alone. John and Linda live in Omaha, and Joe is somewhere on the road. We lost Davy in the last war. I still don't know what for. Matter anymore. You know that old trees just grow stronger, and old rivers grow wilder every day. Ah, but old people just grow lonesome, waiting for someone to say. Anymore. He sits and he stares out the back door screen, and all the news just repeats itself like some forgotten dream that we both sing. Well, someday I'll go call my friend Judy. We used to work together at the factory. Ah, but what will I say if she should ask what's new? Say nothing, what's with you? Nothing much to do. You know that old trees just grow stronger, and old rivers, they grow wilder every day. But old people just grow lonesome, waiting for someone to say hello. So if you're walking down the street sometime, and you should spot some hollow ancient eye, please don't you pass him by and stare as if you didn't care. Say hello. Hello.
Moving to and fro, and oh, there was a time that They traveled to the city we call Vegas, prepared to entertain the folks unclad. Goodbye to mom and pop, they made it to the top by cashing in on every gift they keeps them coming back for more. Pretty legs,
pretty legs,
pretty knockers, that's what makes them spend a little more. Take the ballad, take the rockers, pretty legs and pretty knockers, that's what keeps them coming back for more. I can meet a very special lady, the spring chicken, she can on the go, here to spite her vertigo, the oldest living showgirl in the world.
Feathered boa, a G-string and some tasteful nudity. Then one day wardrobe said, hey, put this on your head. It's only half the size of Tennessee. I've been around since Vegas was invented, and I've worn every costume that they've got. Though some of them were large, this thing's a fucking barge. And I have I mentioned, holy shit, it's hot. Here I am, no need to search up here on my feathered perch, sweating like a whore in church. Boy, it's hot in here. So thick I cannot breathe, hotter than Tel Aviv. If I drop dead, I know you'll freeze. Oi, it's hot in here. Every time I'm all dressed up and looking like a queen, temperature climbs to the top and I'm emitting steam. Oh, it's as hot as it can be, 90 plus, just like me. What's up there you wanna see? Oi, it's hot in here. I'll never forget it, you know. I was getting ready for bed one night with my boyfriend Ernie. Caught a glimpse of myself in the mirror. I said, oh my God, Ernie, look at me. I'm approaching the age of 93. My face has more lines than Disney World. My bosoms have gone so far south, they're speaking Spanish. And my tuchus has fallen and it can't get up. Say something positive to cheer me up. Well, said Ernie, there's nothing wrong with your eyesight.
Boy, it's hot in here.
I'll never forget it, you know. I was brown bagging it with my girlfriend Clementine. We were sitting on a park bench, sharing a tuna fish sandwich. All of a sudden, out of nowhere, a man comes and stands in front of us, opens his trench coat, and flashes us. Clementine immediately had a stroke. Unfortunately, my hand couldn't reach that far.
Boy, it's hot in here.
I'll never forget it, you know. I was downtown shopping with my girlfriend Clementine. The salesman invited her into the changing room for a quickie. Without batting an eyelash, Clementine said, why don't we make it to Yankee? The salesman was flummoxed. He says, what's a Yankee? Oh, says Clementine, it's just like a quickie. But you do it yourself.
Boy, it's hot in here.
I'll never forget it, you know. My boyfriend, Ernie, was away on retreat, searching for his inner child, when I discovered I was in need of physical attention. So I rushed on down to the Saints Be Praised nursing home, where I can still turn a head or two. Sure enough, there was old Mr. Kornfeld. He said to me, Soph, tonight's the night we have relations. Well, we had the... We were laying in bed afterwards, basking in the afterglow and sharing a pell-mell. He said to me, Soph, if I had known you were a virgin, I would have been so much more gentle with you. And I said, well, if I had known you could still get it up, I would have taken off my pantyhose.
Boy, it's hot in here. My boy's in a steady breeze.
I'm cool and feeling great.
When she gets on stage again,
I start to incubate. Oh! I'll never forget it, you know. My girlfriend, Clementine, at the age of 89, decided she needed a little more excitement in her life. Decided she wanted to join the Hells Angels Bikers Club. She sashayed up to a big, scary-looking guy and said, young man, I would like to join your organization. Don't be silly, old lady, he said. We're the toughest gang in the whole state, and you can't join unless you drink. Oh, no problem, says Clementine. I knock back 8 or 10 shots every night after playing pool with the boys. You gotta smoke, too, says the biker. Oh, says Clementine, does marijuana count? Because I burn 2 or 3 doobies every night after playing pool with the boys. Well, now the biker's starting to get a little anxious. Beads of sweat are forming under that mustache. He says, you don't get it, old lady. We're the toughest gang in the whole state. Most of us have been in jail. Have you ever been picked up by the fuzz? No, says Clementine, but I've been swung around by the tits a few times.
Boy, it's hot in here.
I'll never forget it, you know. My boyfriend Ernie said to me, Soph, if you could learn to cook, we could fire the chef. I said, Ernie, if you could learn to fuck, we could fire the chauffeur. Oh, I'm so ashamed. I'm so ashamed. Salty songs and dirty jokes put my daughter through private school. Oh, but it does take a toll on you. Oh my God, I'm exhausted. 2 years of this. How does anybody do this day after day, week after week, month after month, year after year? Come back, Celine, all is forgiven. Oh my God. Cher, Elton, anybody. Donnie and Marie, cross the fucking street. Help me out. Oh, Lord have mercy. All right. Oh, it's coming, I know. Oh. I know what you're thinking. Oh my God, they couldn't pay me enough. Yes, they can. I'll never forget it, you know. I was walking my Chihuahua Puddles. My girlfriend Clementine and her Doberman Pinscher. We came to a bar. Clementine said, ooh, let's go in for a pick-me-up. I said, Clementine, we cannot go into a bar with these goddamn dogs. She said, don't be such a stick in the mud. Follow my lead. And she put on a pair of dark glasses, and she and the Doberman Pinscher walked into the bar. The bouncer stopped her. He said, sorry, lady, no dogs allowed. She said, you don't understand. This is my seeing eye dog. The bouncer was stunned. He said, a Doberman Pinscher? Yes, says Clementine. They're using them now, and they're very good. Well, he let her in. So I figured, what the hell? I put on the dark glasses. I got the Chihuahua by the leash. I walk into the bar. The bouncer stops me. He says, sorry, lady, no dogs allowed. I said, you don't understand. This is my seeing eye dog. The bouncer was stunned. He said, a chihuahua? I said, they gave me a fucking chihuahua? Surgery. That's what keeps them coming back. That's what keeps them coming back. That's what keeps them coming back. You know, I've been telling these jokes for 40 years. Oh my God, no, please, I only bring it up because I want to point out to you that I've been telling them for 40 years and you've been laughing at him for 40 years. Oh my God, even though you heard him a million times, you laugh anyway. If that isn't unconditional love, I don't know what is. So thank you so much for all the joy you've given me back across the lives. What a life you've given me and my family. We are so grateful. You know, I learned most of these jokes back in the 70s when I was just a sprout starting out, but I was too nervous to tell them as myself because in those days they would execute you if you said fuck on the stage. Anyway, I didn't want to die, so I decided, ooh, I think what I'll do is I'll make up a character and put the jokes in her mouth and let her take the heat. And that's what I did. I made up a kind of an old wise ass. I called her Soph. She'd been everywhere and she'd seen everything and done everything. And I remember so clearly when I made her up, I was about 30, and I figured, well, she's probably 60. I see you're way ahead of me on this one. Well, I don't know how many of you have ever had an alter ego, but they can be a real pain in the neck sometimes. And a couple years ago when we were starting out with this show, I was so panic-stricken and terrified because, you know, you can see it's a big show. I've never done a show this big, on a stage this big. And you can see it has a lot of moving parts and big costume changes and set changes and everything. I was just scared out of my wits. And one night, Soph appeared to me at the foot of my bed and she said, Miss M, Miss M, I have news. The showgirl can't go on. Have a nice time in Las Vegas, darling. Good luck. I said, oh, Soph, don't even joke about a thing like that. Of course you're coming with me. You're closing the show. She said, no, I'm not. I said, yes, you are. You've got to. You can't abandon me now. I need you. And she said, ah, you need me. Well, high time you admitted it. But since you did, I'm going to do you a favor. I'm going to show you how a real headliner closes a show. And she picked up a ukulele from the foot of the bed. And I was stunned. I had no idea there was a ukulele at the foot of the bed. She said, Miss M, Miss M, I had a hell of a time. And I will never forget it. You gotta give a little, take a little, let your poor heart break a little. That's the story of, that's the glory of love. You gotta laugh a little, cry a little until the clouds roll by a little. That's the story of, that's the glory of love. As long as there's the two of us, we got the world, we got the world and all. I'm so tired. I'm so fucking tired. Is it over yet? Oh, somebody, oh God, someone rescue me. Maybe if I picked the tempo up, I'd wake up. Let's see how that sounds. Let's see. As long as there, forget it. Maestro, play that for me because I'm too tired to even remember what the chords are. Oh, did I tell you I met the Queen?
Oh,
I've met many queens, but I met the real queen. I met the real one. There's hardly any queens left, but this one particular one, the English one, you know, with the little hairdo. Oh, she's so cute. She's smaller than me, you know, and she has little white hair. She's been wearing, you know, she's still wearing pin curls. I find that so fascinating. I mean, they've heard about rollers and, no, she likes those pin curls. But she was wearing a set of the most amazing diamonds I've ever seen. It was all I could do not to snatch them off her neck, I'm telling you. That's how I spent my Christmas vacation. It was worth it. Did I sing the ballad yet? Was it wonderful? And I will never forget it. If you know it, sing along. You gotta give a little, take a little, and let your poor heart break a little. That's the story of love. You gotta laugh a little, cry a little until the clouds roll by a little. That's the glory of love. As long as there's the two of us, we got the world and all its charms.
Feet, 'cause they know how it goes. Someone gives them a beat. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Showgirl Orchestra, featuring the Fat City Horns, both the boys. What a great time we've had. Oh, and me, I was your hostess. But if I miss him, the people's diva. Thank you so much. So happy and proud to be able to sing this song right here in this gorgeous space. Love can touch us one time and last for a lifetime.
Very well.
Must have been cold there in my shadow to never, never have sunlight on your face. You were content to let me shine. That's your way. You always walked a step behind. So I was the one with all the glory, while you were the one with all the strength. A beautiful face without a name for so long. A beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I would like to be. And I can fly higher than an eagle. 'Cause you are the wind beneath my wings. To go unnoticed, but I got it all here in my heart. I want you to know I know the truth. Of course I know it. I would be nothing without.
you and you and you and you. Thank God for you, the wind beneath my.